Malaysian section of Borneo. This is the first time that Bunker, founder of Barefoot College, and Megan, his right hand, have been here.
It is one of the remotest villages we've come to so far. In some of these villages we've covered in 64 countries, it's never been so inaccessible like this one. Challenged. I feel challenged, and I feel that we will really make a big difference once this happens here.
His goal? To apply Barefoot College's winning formula to help the village of San Sogun to transition out of underdevelopment.
First, the entry point is solar, and then it can be water, can be health. Light, I think, is the most biggest priority for villages all over the world which have no electricity. Always been the case.
Indeed, without renewable energy, the poorest populations must plunder the available resources for wood and spend a fortune buying batteries or fuel to provide light after nightfall.
It's difficult to get diesel all the time because we live so far from everything. Therefore, sometimes we run out of diesel, so we don't do anything except go to sleep.
Bunker and Megan would like to provide solar electricity to this village within 1 year, as they have already done in over 1,000 villages around the world. But to install and ensure the maintenance of solar panels, they're going to need help from the population, and more specifically, from the grandmothers.
All the women, 35 and plus, come and sit here. Kayak!
Three of them, ranging from 35 to 50 years old and scarcely able to read and write, will be chosen by Bunker and Megan to leave here for the first time in their lives to study electronics for 6 months at the Barefoot College in India.
Kalau yang tidak tahan sampai 6 bulan, macam mana?
What if you can't withstand for 6 months?
Oh, she will find it very easy.
Is that when men go outside, they don't come back? But the women always come back. We have trained 600 grandmothers in 64 countries around the world, and every grandmother has gone back home.
Every 6 months, 40 women from all over the world travel to Tilonia, a small Indian village in the state of Rajasthan, to become solar engineers.
This name? This name? No.
Learning the names of the different transistors before mounting them to pre-printed circuits is even more difficult when you don't speak the same language as the teacher.
And the first day, did you understand something?
Nothing. Yeah. We were here, we were watching and wondering, what does he want? What does he want us to do? We didn't understand anything.
Namaste.
Bhagwat, the training manager, easily helps them through this first challenge because he's been there himself. 30 years ago, Bunker took charge of solar power for the entire campus, though he knew nothing about it.
At that time, I thought I could not do this job. But Bunker encouraged me and told me, you have to do this.
So I'm not working solar, I don't know what is the problem, so no.
I told him, I do not have electricity at my home, so I don't know how to make it work.
But Bunker ji helped me, so it's a moral support. Not demoralized, moral support. So you go and try.
This university, the largest in the world to train poor rural populations, both illiterate and semi-illiterate, sprang up between 1984 and 1986, thanks to Barefoot students like Banwar.
So Banwar was from the village. He knew how to build. So we got him with 12 other Barefoot architects who also can't read and write, who built this campus.
Initially, I was scared when Bunker asked me to do it because there was so much money involved. We gathered with a group of villagers and decided how to do it. It was easy, and then it flowed naturally.
It Its construction alone symbolized the entire philosophy of this Gandhi disciple. First, trust in the knowledge of those at the bottom of the pyramid.
All the buildings here in this campus are connected underground to this tank here. You're sitting on a 400,000 liter tank. So if at all there is ever a period of drought, we still have enough water in this campus to give us at least 5 years.
Then make use of the latest in green innovation to ensure sustainable development.
One of the many philosophies of the Barefoot College is to demystify technology and to decentralize the technology and bring it into the hands of very poor people. Even very sophisticated technology like solar, very sophisticated technology like rainwater, we have demystified and brought back to the communities to show. And this is one way place where the engineers can also learn and unlearn how it is important that what the people have thought of thousands of years old is still relevant, still urgent, still applicable today.
Result? Thanks to ancestral techniques and the use of high-tech solar panels, Barefoot College is the first Indian campus to be 100% autonomous for both energy and water. For less than 15 euros per square meter of construction costs. This feat earned Bunker Roy the Aga Khan Prize in 2002.
What do they call it? The Nobel Prize for Architecture? But we gave back $50,000 because they didn't believe that Bhamar, who you met in the morning today, built the whole campus without any architect. The architect made the drawings, but everything else was done by the Barefoot architects. So I haven't lost a sleepless night over it.
Since its creation in 1972, the Social Work and Research Center, more commonly called Barefoot College, has hosted some of the most visionary and influential people on the planet. Today, Pat Mitchell, former head of PBS and CNN executive, is visiting.
Namaste. Oi.
She's come to the source of the bottom-up concept that has already helped over 3 million Barefoot people to take their fate into their own hands.
You know, you're overwhelmed when you see these women from all these different places, all these different languages, all working on this, the project. I find stunning. Yeah. Really, really surprising.
No.
That's why women are going to run the world. Right?
Absolutely.
And maybe figure out how to solve some of the problems we have going on everywhere.
It was the theories that were hard, but practically it was really easy, like breathing. Now I'm really proud at my age to be able to go back to the Congo and be called a solar engineer. I never expected to be that.
The university offers no diploma. The only reward? Leaving with knowledge that will change the life of the community.
You love us, grandmother said we love you.
This was true for Fatima and Mize, who came from Zanzibar. In a few weeks, they will enable 100 families in their fishing village to have electricity for the first time.
I installed this device that allows the household to use 3 lamps and to have a plug where they can charge a phone. I'm not afraid to do what I do because I'm perfectly capable. It's true that it's very unusual in our culture for a woman to get on the roof of a house. People think I'm really strong or really intelligent. They see me as someone important. I'm not used to that. And it's why I love my new job.
Beneficiaries of her services pay an annual subscription for the installation, maintenance, and replacement of solar panels.
There are many advantages to this type of light. Before, we breathed in kerosene fumes, which caused us throat and lung infections. We can breathe normally now, we can see clearly, and most of all, we can light our houses as much as we want. It's wonderful.
Demand for this system from neighboring villages is exploding, as is interest from the governments in other countries. The time has come for the Indian campus in Tolonia to produce offspring.
The women are trained to train. They have this gift, and they want to use that, and they want to train other women, and we need to be able to create the place for them to do that, and to really engage those local governments, whether it's Southeast Asia, Latin America, South America, or the Middle East, or the Pacific region. We hope to have regional presence in all of those regions.
Five training centers are being built, like here in Zanzibar. Eventually, an army of solar engineers will bring electricity to all the rural areas that have been left behind.
If we stick to a community-based model and we mobilize people at the bottom of the pyramid, we're talking about more than 40% of the population on the Earth. It's, of course, it's the key. It will have the hugest effect on climate that we can possibly have as a world.
This model is a vivid demonstration that renewables are reducing global poverty and expanding energy access. The Barefoot College has cleared a path for others to follow in their footsteps.